thing when I sit back and soak it all in and really ponder on what happened, this is probably going to be ranked right up in the top five championships I ever won. Not many people can say that, huh?
As a kid, you always set goals. And that was one, NBA was one of those goals like, man, I'm going to be able to accomplish this. Little small town kid, you don't have access to this stuff. Just get your education. And if it happens, it happens. And next thing you know, you look around, you're playing against all these great players that you idolize and wanted to be like. And for me, it was more than a dream come true for me, because basketball was one of those things you just played for fun. You played for the enjoyment, for the competition, just for the trash talking amongst friends. And now you're doing it on a stage where people all around the world are watching your level of competition, how you play, talking about you. And it's just one of those things where you sit back and says, man, I played in the NBA. Man, I won championships. Man, I played against some of the greatest players that would ever play this game. And for me, when you wake up in the morning, you just say, man, can I rewind my life one time so I can just do it again?
Yeah.
It's because you'll never be able to do something as special as this.
I don't know how many times I've said it, but I can't say it enough. I love you. I love you for the way that you cheered when we won our first championship. I love you for the way that you cheered when we won our second championship. And I love you for how you love me right now and how you're sending me out on this positive note.
We happen to play, I think, in the golden age of the NBA. I mean, you know, we see the value of our teams. When we got to the teams, what, you know, 20 million, 40 million, now it's 400 million. So, you know, just watching the growth of this league and being a part of the most special time as far as the types of players that came through, just a ridiculous group of talent and watching it grow. Being able to play in this time, play with guys like you guys and get to know you guys, and it was incredible.
Nice jersey.
I know, my last jersey. It's all stained with champagne. It stinks now. We'll have to wash it.
And I can use it when I grow up?
You can use it when you grow up, all right? It's a little big right now, but you'll grow into it.
And I look back on it now and I just think, you know, I mean, you know, even standing on that podium for the 92 Olympics. I mean, I grew up watching the Olympics. Man, I grew up watching, you know, the Mark Spitzes and the, you know, the Mary Lou Rettons and all that. But here we were making Olympic history. And you know, who gets to do that kind of stuff? You know, I remember as a rookie, me and Sean Elliott sitting at practice thinking, man, this is ridiculous. We get to come play basketball every day. This is our job. We get paid for this.
No classwork.
And it has been an unbelievable journey. And over the years, you know, just learning to love basketball and just love the atmosphere and just love the smell of the gym and working out and growing up. You know, when I play against, you know, Michael or Scottie or Karl Malone, you know, those guys, they make you grow up. You have no choice. You're going to get stronger. Like you said, I came in at 235. You know, Karl's like, I'm like, okay, 15 more pounds. Let me go find 15 more pounds. Yeah. But, you know, and so it has just been an unbelievable journey, you know. And for all of us, it's just a step to that next phase of our life. But yeah, we've all been very blessed to be able to play this game together.
And I want to thank all you fans here tonight who made me understand what it really means to love Chicago.
You know, for me, basketball has been everything. It's been an opportunity to live my passion, something that I enjoy doing. And you know, it reminds me of growing up as a kid. You know, we all out on the playgrounds playing, and you know, our dreams and our aspirations is to someday play at a higher level, whether it's college or professional. And to be able to live it out fully, especially me, a kid that went to college, no scholarship, a walk-on, and still, you know, had my dream in vision that one day I'll be playing against some of the greatest players in the game, and I'll be right there with them, and people will remember me for that. And to be able to live that dream out is just been amazing. And, you know, I want to thank the NBA just for, you know, giving me that opportunity to play on such a great stage with some of the greatest players in the world, some of the greatest people, and, you know, some lifelong friends as well.
Thank
you. Thank you for all of the support. Thank you for your love. I am honored to be here. This is a great night. Thank you. I'm overwhelmed.
I think being able to play in the NBA was all of our dreams. Back when I was a kid, we had the game of the week. We only had one game, no cable. We had like three channels, guys. It was color TV, though, all right? It wasn't black and white. But you only had three channels, and every Sunday you have a game of the week. And so I would watch all the pros and try to emulate their moves. I'd be on the playground 6-7 hours a day. So I played a lot of basketball. Why? Because we loved it. That's what we loved to do. You know, we didn't have cell phones, video games, internet, and all that stuff. So we had to do something we loved to do. It was my hobby. I loved it. Never thought I'd be good enough to even play in college, not even in high school. So to be able to play and play, you know, Five Slamma Jamma, that was, you know, straight luck, a dream come true. And then to go to the NBA and play against some of the all-time greats, are you kidding me? Coming out of Houston, Texas, never thought it would be possible. But, I mean, it's changed my life. I've traveled the world. My family's traveled with me. I've met new people from all over the world. I get to hang out with guys like this and talk about the game that we love. Does it get any better? Wake me up. I don't want to wake up. Don't pinch me. Don't wake me up.